I give the call to the member for Wannon.
Thanks, Mr Deputy Speaker. And that was an enlightening speech by the member for Fraser, because it was enlightening, and it showed one clear thing. He started talking about the need for people to demonstrate a plan, and I thought we were going to get here from the member for Fraser what the opposition's plan is for superannuation. But he couldn't last 4.5 minutes talking about superannuation. He had to get on to transparency of taxation when he hit about the 4-minute 15-second mark. It shows that there is no plan over there. They don't care about the future of Australia's superannuation industry. But, Mr Deputy Speaker, we do on this side, because we understand how important that superannuation is going to be and is for Australians. The Australian superannuation pool is projected to reach $9 trillion. $9 trillion by 2040. So why, Mr Deputy Speaker, are we bringing this measure into the parliament today? It's because we want the best people governing the retirement savings of Australians. And I'm going to say that again. We want the best people governing the retirement savings of Australians. That is why we have put this measure into the parliament. Once again, what are we talking about? A projection that superannuation savings will reach $9 trillion by 2040. So why on that side wouldn't they want the best people governing those retirement savings? This is common sense. This is making sure that we will get the best returns for those ordinary workers that those people on that side like talking about. We will get the best returns for them because we will have the best people on those boards. And yet you oppose such a common sense initiative. You have to ask yourselves, why. Ask yourselves why. We don't need to tell you. You need to ask yourselves why. Ask that question, and then you might learn. You might learn something. You might learn about who you're beholden to and why you're beholden to them. Because what we want to see, is the best people running Australians' retirement savings. And this is what this debate is all about. Now, why or how did we get to this? Two independent reviews have recommended these changes. Two independent reviews. The Cooper Review and the Financial System Inquiry. They recommended these changes. So why are those opposite opposing them? Once again, ask yourselves why. There are practical reasons for these measures. We've already seen where there's been mergers of equal representation super funds. They've failed because there couldn't be agreement on who would take the positions on the boards. So there are practical reasons why these changes are being brought forward. And let's make it clear. Let's make it very clear. The bill does not prevent union representation on these funds. It doesn't prevent them, right? All it says is that we want the best people on these boards. Let's look at the sensible way it's been introduced. How has it been introduced? With a 3-year transition. So funds have got 3 years to move down this path. Who's supporting it? The Association of Superannuation Funds of Australia, the Financial Services Council, APRA, the Australian Institute of Company Directors. Who's already heading down this path? There are already industry funds heading down this path. As the previous speaker on our side superbly mentioned, First State Super, Host Plus, Prime Super, Uni Super, Vic Super, Catholic Super, they're already heading down this path. So why, when we've got $9 trillion forecast to be under managed in the superannuation pool, why would you oppose it? Now, we on this side could tell you why you're doing it. But you're not going to learn that. You're going to learn from that. You have to learn it from yourselves. Ask that question why you are opposing this.